Hello everyone, welcome back to Zeitgeist. Today we are going to learn a story called Slattery the God by Isaac Bashevis Singer. Slattery the God is a story written by the Jewish American novelist. The story takes place among the Jewish community in Poland. The story is about the attachment between human beings and animals. So the story takes place in the background called in the background of Jewish community. The Hanukkah festival is about to take place. Hanukkah is a celebration, a festival of the community, a festival of lights. It is something like our Deepavali. So Slattery the God tells about the life of the Jewish people, Jewish community living in Poland. You can see here the cover of the book in which this story was first published. It is called Slattery the God and Other Stories, an illustrated volume. So the story is a very heartwarming one, and I'm sure that you will all like it. See, this is a summary or the contents of the story so that you can easily understand it when you read it from the text. Once upon a time, in a village in Poland, there lived a man named Reuven. He was a furrier by profession. Who is a furrier? Furrier is one who makes garments, clothes, dress using fur. രോമക്കുപ്പായം ഉണ്ടാക്കുന്നയാളാണ് ഫറിയർ. ഹിസ് ഫാമിലി കൺസിസ്റ്റഡ് ഓഫ് ഹിസ് വൈഫ് ലിയ, ദ എൽഡസ്റ്റ് സൺ ആരോൺ, ആൻഡ് ടു ഡോട്ടേഴ്സ് അന്ന ആൻഡ് മെറിയം. ദാറ്റ് ഇയർ ഇൻ വിച്ച് ദിസ് സ്റ്റോറി ടേക്സ് പ്ലേസ്, ദാറ്റ് ഇയർ വിൻ്റർ വാസ് slow and mild. Winter season was not so strong. The family faced financial difficulties as Reuven did not get enough work. So it was a bad year for Reuven. It is a question actually, why that year was bad for Reuven. That is why I have given it in bold writing. Thus, Reuven decided to sell his god, Slattery, to Fable the butcher. Reuven asked Aaron to go to the town and sell the god. So, hope you have understood the premise. Reuven is a furrier. As winter was not so strong, he didn't get enough work. And his financial conditions were a bit difficult, so he decided to sell his god Slattery to the butcher called Fable. They loved the god. The family loved the god. When they heard that the god is to be taken to the butcher, Leah, the mother, wiped the tears from her eyes. Aaron's younger sisters, Anna and Miriam, cried loudly. So the Slattery, the animal, was actually, the god was actually a pet of the family. It was not their intention to kill it, to sell it to the butcher, but as they were, their financial conditions were not so fine, that's why they decided to kill it. Mother was unhappy, Aaron's sisters were unhappy, but still they had to do it because their life was at stake. Slattery was good and patient when she departed with Aaron. So Slattery was a very good-natured god. She trusted human beings. Who? The god trusted human beings. She knew that they always fed her, gave food to her, and never did any harm at all. When Aaron led her to the town road, Slattery was astonished. Why? Slattery was astonished. Slattery has never been led to the direction of the town before. So Slattery was really surprised why the young master Aaron is taking her to the town. On the way to the town, when it started getting dark, the weather changed. Heavy snowfall started. Within a short time, the road became completely white with snow and they lost their way. Wind became very cold and loud. Snow accumulated everywhere thickly. So that is the climate of this particular countryside. So it was winter. Winter was not so strong till then. Then as they started their trip to the town, Aaron and the god, the climate changed. Heavy snowfall started and snow everywhere and they lost their way. Beneath the thick snow, Aaron's boots touched the softness of plowed field. Thus Aaron realized that he was not traveling on the road. As they moved on, Aaron finally felt something like a snow-clad hill on the way. Suddenly he realized that it is a big haystack. Haystack ennu parayundu vaikol kunaya. See, as Aaron was walking, his boot felt that the ground is not regular. It is plowed. Plowed means uludu marachu. So then Aaron realized that he was not actually walking through the street, but walking through the road, but he had lost his way. But they still continued. It was unable to, they were unable to find the road in between. So finally they reached something like a hill, a snow-clad, snow-covered hill. What was this hill actually? Suddenly he realized that it is a big haystack. Haystack means vaikol kuna. Then Aaron had an idea. He made a hole in the haystack, big enough for him and Slattery to get in. Aaron knew that within the haystack it will be warm and Slattery will have enough food. So Aaron had an idea that he made a hole within that haystack, just enough for him and the god to get in. And another advantage was that the god will get enough food, as it is hay. Both entered the haystack. Slattery started eating and filling her stomach. Aaron made a hole for the air movement and made themselves comfortable. Aaron ate 2 slices of bread and cheese and drank milk from Slattery's udders. So Slattery had milk within her udders and Aaron drank from it. Slattery was a patient, good-natured god. She wanted to thank Aaron for bringing her to a home made of food, and she was happy to give Aaron her milk. So even in between the danger, they found a comfortable place. It was completely dark outside. The heavy storm and snowfall continued, but within the haystack they felt warm. Aaron and Slattery felt attached to each other. The attachment between human beings and animal, that is the theme of the story. He felt she was like a sister to her. He hated to sell her to the butcher. In the loneliness, he started talking to her. Both Aaron and Slattery were grateful to each other for saving their lives from the snowfall. See, both were grateful to each other because it was Aaron who found this safe place for her, food for her. And it is the milk of the god that helped him to quell his hunger. For 3 days, Aaron and Slattery stayed in the haystack for 3 days. By the third night, snow stopped. While inside the haystack, Aaron dreamed of green fields, trees covered with blossoms, clear brooks, and singing birds. That is spring season. So Aaron was dreaming about green fields, tree covered blossoms, clear brooks, singing birds, etc. Clear brook means stream. On the fourth day, he heard the ringing of bells from the vehicles of a farmer. He understood that the haystack is not far away from the road. Aaron decided not to sell Slate. He decided to go back to the village instead of going to the town and sell that goat. Aaron's family was worried. They feared that Aaron had lost his way. Suddenly, one of their neighbors announced to them that Aaron and Slate were coming. So the family was completely happy. Family was rejoiced. Aaron told them how they stayed in the haystack, how Slate fed him with her milk. The family felt grateful to the god, and nobody ever thought of selling her. As the cold weather arrived, as winter became strong, Riven got the work again. His financial worries were thus over. The Hanukkah festival came. All became very happy. Once in a while, Aaron would ask Slate whether she remembered the 3 nights they spent together in the haystack. So that's the end of the story. It was about an incident in the life of Aaron and how both were trapped in the snow. See, this is a haystack in the winter. How a haystack is covered with snow in the winter. This is a picture of Hanukkah festival celebration. It is something like the Deepavali. See, fur garments, clothes made of fur of animals. That is a profession of Reuven. And this is the writer Isaac Bashevis Singer. So watch this video again if you want to understand the story. Then try to read the original story from the text. Thank you.